Zenkai Awakening! Oh boy, I have a lot to say about this, and I'm sure you do as well. So in the comment section of this video, feel free to kind of give your best feedback in regards to how you personally would want to see Zenkai Awakening change. It's not going away. So if you say, get rid of it, they're not going to do it. And the reason why we know that is because, well, we just got Boo, and we just got Goku Black recently, and based on how this trend is going, we're probably going to be getting Zenkai Awakening units once every couple weeks, which is not the worst thing if you improve the system. You know, one thing I will always praise the Dragon Ball Legends team for is being able to take, old horrible updates and make them good. You know, over the course of the past 2 years in the game, they've had a lot of terrible choices when they released the updates, but they severely improved by making those better. For example, training. If you guys remember originally, when level 1500 and 2000 or whatever it was the initial level cap, to level up something from 0 to 2000, it would take hours. Now it takes minutes at 5000. So it's really cool seeing how they would take, you know, an initial update and make it actually viable and acceptable by the entire player base. They could do that with Zenkai Awakening, you know? Honestly, I think the whole Zenkai system will be a lot more accepted if everybody can do it with ease. Now, when I say with ease, I don't mean like taking away the complete grind from it, but I'm talking about making it accessible by everybody. If you're free to play, you can Zenkai. If you're pay to play, you can Zenkai. Even if you play briefly, like once every couple days, you can Zenkai. That should be the case. That should absolutely be the case. If everybody could Zenkai, it would make the system a lot more balanced, a lot more fair, and I think no one would have a problem with it, if that makes sense. At least that's my opinion. The thing about right now is Zenkai is so paywall locked and grind locked that no one wants to do it. And I've done it before, you know? I've done the Beerus grind. I know how much goes into it, because something I like to do before I really judge something is to test it out myself and see like how it actually is. And after doing it, I never want to do it again. I'm going to at some point again when they buff my favorite old units, but I never want to do it again just because of how much goes into it. So let's go down this list. Number one, remove the 7-star requirement. There's no point of it. There's no reason for it. You mean to tell me if I have Beerus, LF Beerus right now at 6 stars, he is the worst unit in the game, but at 7 stars, he's like top tier? Something about that doesn't sit right, you know? I get it, old units, whatever, but like Beerus at 6 stars? Like why does he have a requirement? Let me Zenkai him at 1 star. Let me Zenkai him at 2 stars, at 3 stars. Well, technically, you summon at 3 stars anyways. But point is, let me Zenkai this man the second I have him. Because you should be able to power up these units after you get them. Just because, I mean, I don't know. It's just kind of scummy to not be able to. So get rid of that, number one. Number two, friendship grind is god-awful. Nobody has time to do it. Nobody wants to do it. And if you force me to play it, I'm not going to have fun. That's just how it is right now. So you have to, if you do the free path, so if you get the level 1 Zenkai for the current units available, the last step always makes you required to have a friendship level 10. And it's absolutely the worst thing in the game. You know, I've done it once now, and that was with Beerus. And after that, I never want to do it again. I have currently Zenkai'd the Red Goku, and I got everything except for the last step. I summoned for the last step. I skipped the friendship thing with Goku, and I skipped the friendship thing with Buu as well. And I feel like that's why they designed like that. And if you design something like that, it's just kind of shady. So I feel like either add a new way to friendship grind, which gives you a lot of friendship points, or two, just remove it completely. Or even just make it like level 5 or something. I don't really know, but like level 10 is too much considering the fact that you're gonna have to be doing this like once every couple weeks. No one's gonna wanna do this. Something else I want to talk about is reduce the orb grind. Now, a lot of you guys probably haven't experienced the true horror of Zenkai grinding because you haven't done it, which is smart. Once you get something woken, you can't actually use it. In my case, I think I spent 17,000 crystals to Zenkai Beerus at level 7, and guess what? It didn't matter because I didn't have the orbs to actually activate his abilities. The way it works right now is once you get to Zenkai level 1, you unlock the initial abilities that they get, you know, through the Zenkai system. And then with every single Zenkai level you get, you know, you get more of those, like, buffs, like, you know, how it has, like, the, for example, in Beerus' case, you get, if it's God Key in green, you get all these extra boosts, you get stuff like that. But they also get two unique abilities that are hidden on the third path and on the sixth path on the actual orb system. But the thing is you need a lot of orbs to actually get to that point. And the worst part is you have to like go all the way around twice. So if you look at the actual panel, you have to go from the left side to all the way down and the right side all the way down. Once you have that connected, then you can activate the ability. And you can finally get that unique ability as well. That in itself is hell. And the reason why is because it takes roughly 2,500 of every single Zenkai level to be able to Zenkai something fully. Which took me, I'm going to say, more than 2 months. It took me more than 2 months for Beerus. Which is insane! Think about that. You spend 17,000 crystals, in my case, and then you spend an extra 2 months just to be able to use that. That's too much. For a mobile game, too much. Even for an MMO, that's still too much. Like, No one wants to do that grind, you know? So get rid of that. Either reduce the orb grind significantly by allowing us to have like an orb event in the, you know how they have the current orbs right now where you can get those regular orbs? They could have Zenkai orbs as like an obtainable method as well. Or just when you do co-op, make either co-op more, give you more points, more coins, so you can actually buy the actual orbs from the shop, or just significantly drop them. Because as you guys know, if you do co-op right now, you get the Zenkai Adventures, but it gives you next to none. Like literally, if you do the Zenkai Adventures, for example, let's say you do the Gogeta grind right now, you get two adventures, you know, a yellow adventure, for example. If you do those for an hour, you'll probably get like 12 orbs. And if you need 2,500 of each, you kind of do the math for yourself. It will take a long time. So that needs a change in itself. Again, it should not take that long. I get, you know, they're trying to make Zenkai one of those things that's so hard to obtain because you get that more powerful, but no one wants to do that in a mobile game. Again, if you force me to play, I'm not going to want to do it. Just how it is. Something else I would also change is add dupes towards the Zenkai boost. So for example, let's say I have a 14-star Goku Black or a 14-star Goku. If I pull a dupe, right now the way it works is once you're maxed out, you just get 600 medals that go into this special shop that basically lets you rebuy all the PvP equipment, which is cool, but there's really no use of it. You know, if you've done PvP at all when that equipment was out, you probably have those already maxed out. So basically, when you have something maxed out at 14 stars, those medals you get, they do nothing. So why not do something with it? Put it towards Zenkai. You know, if I have a 14-star Beerus, which I don't, by the way, but if I did, and I pull an extra LF Beerus at the rate that it is, I would be upset knowing that I just got something so rare, but it does nothing. So take those 600 coins and put it towards the Zenkai Awakening. I mean, I don't see why that would be an issue. You should do that. Something else I would do is add a daily Zenkai Summon. I mentioned this in my last video. Right now, the way the game works is when the game resets, all your banners that are available will let you do a discount summon for 20 crystals, one single summon. Right now, it costs 300 crystals to do a multi-summon on the banner. Why not do something where every single day we get maybe like for 20 crystals, you can do a quick summon for multi-summon and it gets Zenkai points. Because at that point, you're allowing like the player base to also work on getting Zenkai Awakening power over the course of the future. Because at that point, it becomes more accessible as well. I don't see why that would be an issue, because right now no one's doing it, so it's like, if anything, it's going to make people want to do it more. I don't really know, but like, just add the daily discount for Zenkai Awakening as well, because I'll tell you right now, if the daily Awakening was a thing, or daily discount was a thing, I absolutely would have been doing it every single day at reset, but I just don't, because I'd rather save my crystals for actual units that I can use. Because another problem right now, it's like, you are forced, let's say you're a free-to-play player, you're forced to either save your crystals and use them towards new units that come out, or you could, you know, use them for Zenkai Awakening, but then you will get nothing out of it. If you summon, like, let's say the brand new Majin 21, if you summon her, you can use her immediately. But if you decide to save your crystals and put it towards Zenkai, you can't do anything with it because you still have to get orbs, you still have to max out the unit, and then you're just not playing the game. You're stuck more grinding than playing the game, and that's just not fun. So, I mean, take it as you want it, but that system needs to change itself. And for love of God, speaking of the banner, increase the Zenkai drops. Because right now, the way it works is for 300 Chrono Crystals, you do a multi-summon on the Zenkai banner, you know, which LF Beerus, Broly, Goku Black, whatever. And you basically get a multi-summon of 10 units that vary from 5 points, 15 points, 30 points, and 70 points. With 70 points being basically the Sparking equivalent. So on average, when you do a multi-summon on a Zenkai banner, you usually get about 70 points. Now, if you need to get to 7,000, you do the math. It gets pretty expensive. So either decrease the cost of Zenkai multi-summons to like 100 Chrono Crystals, or significantly increase the drop rate for them. Because like, I don't see why Zenkai Orbs or Zenkai Awakening Power has the same rate as Sparkings. It's kind of crazy. It's insane. Like I said, it took me 17,000 for Beerus to get to level 7. I believe Goresh took way longer. So it just comes down to the luck factor as well. And again, it's too much. It needs to be changed. Something else I would also do is maybe add a vote for the next Zenkai, because at least at that point you're involved in a community, and it lets us kind of prepare. If I know that, you know, Yellow Frieza, for example, was to get a Zenkai Awakening next month, I would absolutely be preparing right now. I would get that freshman to 10 and be ready for it. You know, right now, all my favorite units, I am working daily in the Let's Fight stage to get this, to friendship to level 10. And I've been doing basically all my LOE units. So if my LOE stuff ever gets Zenkai Awakening, I'm ready. But as far as right now, it's kind of a mystery. So when the stuff like Goku Black pops out or Good Buu, I usually think, well, wait a minute. If I invest my time getting this card awoken, what's going to come out next month? You know, do I want to use all my resources right now available to Zenkai this when there's something else to come out next month that could be even better? Like, at least, like, give us kind of like a heads up so we can prepare. And I think that would make, again, one of those things that would make the whole Zenkai grind a lot better. Something else I want to talk about is balance as well, because as you guys know, a lot of the Zenkai units have been pretty powerful. You know, Majin Buu and Beerus being at the top of the list. You know, my Majin Buu is level 1, and at level 1, he's crazy. At level 1, when I hit his second, his two new unique abilities, it's still crazy. Beerus easily is top tier. You know, put him next to Whis at level 7, and you're going to be bodying people left and right. So there's also another issue of making him more balanced and more fair. I feel like Goku Black is just right, and so are the other ones. But again, I haven't really heard much about it because no one uses it because the system sucks. But balance is something else to kind of think about when you go into this, because you know you don't want to have these old units so crazy balanced that it makes PvP completely unfun. But the thing is when it comes out of balance, honestly, I feel like the more people they can actually Zenkai awaken their units, the better it'll become in the long run. Because at this point, since no one's really doing it, when you come across a Zenkai team, you're not gonna have fun. Whereas if everybody can Zenkai something, it's like, okay, at least I'm ready. You know, maybe I can bring out my Zenkai unit against their Zenkai unit and then have an actual balanced war. So I think balance could even be better across the next couple months if they make the whole Zenkai system more obtainable. And something else I want to talk about before I end this video is bring back the old buff system. Because another reason why we as a player base don't really like the Zenkai system is before, every couple months, they would take the bottom 5 EX and Sparking units and buff them. And what would happen is it would take old units that are not viable at that point anymore, viable at that point, and that was cool. And something else I like about that is, for example, if I summon for someone like Red Gogeta, I would know that, you know what, a couple months from now, he might get his buff and he'll be still viable. And that made it really, really fun to summon, because you knew that no matter how much time passes, if they get that buff, they'll be viable at that point in the game. And right now we don't have that anymore. So something I would do is, if you're going to keep Zenkai Awakening as a thing, maybe once a month, you can take the bottom most EX unit, the bottom most Sparking unit, introduce like a Rising Battle type of system where, you know, you do the Rising Battle event, maybe 10 stages or something like that. And once you beat that stage 10 times, then you get those buffs. They don't necessarily have to be as crazy as Zenkai Awakening, but it could be in the same level how it was before. Because at that point, we're also getting the old buff system back, and we're getting the Zenkai system. So you get like the best of both worlds. Again, the thing about Legends is they don't seem to release stuff because they're malicious or anything, or disconnected from the player base. I think they have decent ideas. It's just that a lot of times they're really horribly executed. But if you tweak them, make them more fun and more usable, more acceptable by the player base, you know, make them actually good, we won't have a problem with it. And in the case of Zenkai Awakening, I don't necessarily want to say get rid of it, but if you take it and make it more balanced upon where anybody can do it, whether you're pay to play or free to play, I think Zenkai Awakening could have a good future in this game. Again, the concept of taking an old unit and making it good to the point where it's very, very viable at that point in the meta, I think is cool. But it's just right now, it's just so hard to do. It takes so much time. It takes a lot of money if you're pay to play. Like, it's too much. That system in itself needs to change. You know, the fact that I have to repay to use a unit that I paid for months ago, I think is bullshit. And that in itself should be something to kind of think about. I'm talking to you, the Legends team, by the way. That's something to think about as well. Like, the fact that, like, you know, we bought your units, you know, months ago and have to basically pay even more to use them right now, it just doesn't sit right, you know? So if you balance that out and make it more acceptable, more better, I guarantee you a lot more people will be happy with it. At least I think, I don't know. Comment section below, let me know your thoughts on the Zenkai Awakening system, how you personally would change it. You know, over the course of the last couple of months, I have seen a lot of good feedback around it, you know. And I feel like if the Legends team gets the correct information, the correct amount of feedback, they can take the Zenkai Awakening system and make it fun, make it very, very enjoyable. But for right now, how it is, it ain't it. It ain't it, Chief. So yeah, let me know down below what you guys think about the Zenkai system, how you personally want to change it, any other feedback that you have in regards to that I missed. Obviously, this is just stuff that I have off the top of my head. There's probably a lot of stuff that I missed myself, and I want this to be kind of like one of those things that we just kind of talk about as a community down below. And if you have anything that you can also make it better, then let me know. But otherwise, thank you guys for watching. Hopefully, this changes. Hopefully, we can continue to improve the state of the game. And hopefully they listen. So yeah, all we can really do is kind of get our opinions out there, our feedback out there, and kind of cross our fingers that it happens. Thank you guys for watching. My name is Rhymestyle. I'll see you guys in the comment section below. Peace.